Well, we've come to the moment of truth, the 15th stage, the individual time trial. The riders moving down to Trieste now, which is over towards the borders of the old Yugoslavia. And it is there now where the riders will face up to a 40 kilometres time trial, 25 miles. There's a climb which takes them up to the 11.5 kilometre point, and then it gently rolls off the hill down to the flat finish. This is the situation. Pantani now 22 seconds, that's all, behind the new leader Zuller. Tonkov, the ever-present Tonkov, is third. Guerini, because of that ride, is up into fourth. And, you know, you mustn't underrate Guerini. He's a good rider in the Giro d'Italia. Well, this is the start, Paul, of Pavel Tonkov.
But out on the course, coming in with the fastest time, is a man who always puts a good time in the time trials. Sergei Gonchar comes to the line with a new best time of 45 minutes and 31 seconds.
Well, that's going to be the marker. Even Pantani may not, and I would say should not, get towards that time. Gonchar shot to the fore last year in the Giro d'Italia with a great time trial. He went on to become a medalist in the World Time Trial Championship. Now he's in with the best time for the 40 kilometres. Back to Tonkov.
Well, Tonkov, a man capable of putting in a very good time trial, but the man I think who must certainly be one of the big favourites for this stage has to be Alex Zuller. He'll be starting in last position, and that will give him the advantage of knowing what the intermediary times are of all the other riders. And here he is coming off the starting ramp right now, resplendent in the pink jersey on a very fast time trial machine. And right in front of him on the road is going to be Pavel Tonkov.
Well, big Alex knows what it's like to be a world champion of the time trial. And now we're looking at the big boys all out on the course, separated only by their start time here. And remember, Gonchar is in with the best time, and that's a marker. Here comes Michele Bartoli, not surprisingly, slipping down. This is a partway check here, Paul. Plus 36 seconds, so he's fourth at partway. That's a pretty good performance by Bartoli.
It certainly is, but it's the early part of the course when you have to get into your rhythm straight away, and Alex Zuller looks very comfortable on this early climb. As you said, it takes them up to 11.5 kilometres, and then it's 30 kilometres down to the finish. Here's an intermediary check, though, for Andrea Noah, the early leader. He goes through in fourth place, almost 1.25 minutes off the mark.
Well, Zuller is riding very strongly. The checks are indicating he is nibbling a short lead here. Gonchar is the leader, who's won the time trial stage for the past 2 years, don't forget. Tonkov, 1.4 seconds down, Paul. That's not a lot as we see the arrival of Belli.
Well, Belli thinking more about the days to come and the work he's going to have to do for the overall leader, Alex Zuller. He comes through in 20th place, 2 minutes 45 seconds off the leaderboard. But Marco Pantani's coming up to the intermediary point there. We get a chance to see just how well Pantani is riding in a discipline that he normally doesn't like very much.
So Pantani a little bit off the pace here. It's 11th place and losing ground. All these riders are pretty hot time trial riders. Pantani, don't forget, may have used a lot of energy yesterday to that mountain top finish. He's going through 17th at the moment, over 73 seconds down on Gonchar, who has finished. Huge crowds here now waiting to see what Alex Zuller can do, as he will head up now towards that same checkpoint. At the moment, though, it is Gonchar, Tonkov and Carlos Dominguez, by the way, who's third best.
Look at this, Zuller still inside the time of Sergei Gonchar, a winner last year of a stage, a time trial stage in the Tour of Italy. And this is the terrain that Alex Zuller really can excel in, the time trial. He's a specialist at that, he's been the world champion, and he's well inside the time set by Gonchar early on at this intermediary point at half distance.
Well, Gonchar, remember, lost the world title to Laurent Jalabert last year, and look at that, he's gone 36 seconds to the good. So Zuller is riding a superb time trial, and if he keeps this up with the toughest part behind him, he's going to increase his overall lead over the others. We're looking again at Tonkov. He was second on the road, he's now third.
Powerful rider. Oscar Kamen's in, the champion of Switzerland, coming up to the line as well. A great performance by him going across in fifth place, but 1 minute 38 seconds off the leader. But out on the course, I have to tell you, Phil, Alex Zuller looking very good. Another good performance coming in. Michele Bartoli, second for him.
Wow, in fact, third as he slips up, 1 minute 18 seconds down. Look at the speed of here of Tonkov, 56.7 kilometres an hour. You know, if Zuller is going quicker, then we are on to see the fastest ever time trial in the history of the Giro d'Italia.
And looking there at the figure of Marco Pantani a little further down the road, in fact, you will see the pink jersey on the shoulders of Alex Zuller, who started 2 minutes behind him in this time trial, and now he's got the fantastic sight of having the leader of the King of the Mountains right in front of him. And that will spur him on, because that means he will at least get a 2 minute advantage over the little climber from Pantani.
Well, the roads are nice and wide, they're very flat, the sun is up in the sky, it's a warm day, and Pavel Tonkov should be second best when he gets the line. Andrei Noah comes in 21st for him. So his race will continue, and the capture here of Pantani by Zulla, and he flies by him. This is an incredible piece of performance here. Alex Zulla cutting up a path towards victory in the Giro d'Italia, even with the mountains that are still to come.
Incredible speed by Alex Zulla there, and I think Marco Pantani will be reasonably happy to the fact that he's only lost 2 minutes so far on a man at the specialist at this kind of event, Alex Zulla. Zulla flying along here well in excess of 55 kilometers an hour, looking very calm and collected and in control of the situation, and all Pantani can do now is try and keep the flying Swiss rider in his sights.
The face of Pavel Tonkov, the winner of this tour 2 years ago, Gotti now out of it and no chance of repeating his victory of last year. Tonkov, the obvious candidate. The best time in is Sergei Gonchar. Tonkov is coming in, he's behind Gonchar, and he's going to slot in third place at the moment. He won't be too happy with that.
Marco Pantani still can see the shadow in front of him of the pink jersey, Alex Zulla, a big armada of machines right behind him. The advantage now of Zulla around about 250 metres, but Zulla really pushing as much as he can into that big chainring he's got on the front there. 56 tooth on the front chainring, and I would think his smallest sprocket at the back is going to be around about 11, so that will be an incredibly big gear that he's just making mincemeat out of.
Well, Zulla will now be the next rider to finish in the overall classification as he continues now. Tonkov is in, he's caught Pantani. Pantani's going to keep him in his sights at all costs. But even so, Zulla has pulled away. There's the time of Gonchar, and there is the time of Alex Zulla. Tonkov now comes on the screen. I think there's something actually wrong with the timings here. 45:38 for Alex Zulla. I actually think that is wrong. And Zulla has produced the best time of the day, and we'll get confirmation of that, I'm sure. The screen was wrong. I think they were wrong when they put Tonkov's time up. They're slightly out of sync, I think. That's out of our control, as now the arrival of Marco Pantani heading up towards the finish. And in fact, Alex Zulla has been declared the winner, his time amended. So we're not sure what Pantani's doing now, but they're giving him 24th place at the moment. The time of Alex Zulla, and there it is amended, 44:38. That is a record average speed for any of the Giro d'Italia time trials. The previous best, by the way, was Yevgeny Berzin a few years ago. So Zulla beats Gonchar and Tonkov, and Carlos Dominguez is the other rider. So Alex Zulla has increased his overall lead in the Giro d'Italia in 2 days of excellent racing, but of course with the Dolomites still to come, and therefore you can never count out Marco Pantani, who may be the leader of the King of the Mountains, but he really does want to win the Giro d'Italia. And what about Pavel Tonkov, Paul, because he's a man who is really looking good.
But going into the last week of this Giro, Phil, I have to tell you one thing. Alex Zulla is looking very confident indeed. Tactically, he's ridden perfectly, but certainly he's put a lot of effort into that first 10 days of this race, and I feel that he may well pay for it a little later on. Tonkov certainly looking like a possible future winner.
And a little bit uphill today towards the end as the riders move away on the 16th stage from Udine to Asiago. Tomorrow, of course, is the day they fear most in the high mountains, and there may be a few rather tired legs today, Paul, especially after that time trial yesterday.
And once again, you can see the big long line here of a breakaway that's got clear. They've managed to steal away from the rest of the big heads of state of this year's Giro d'Italia, because everybody realises that a lot of the big men in this race will be thinking about the big mountain stage tomorrow.
People like Piccolini are in here, Bettini's in here, Ferrigato, Fontanelli, Nicola Loda, a good finisher there. Klaus Møller is even here from Denmark. He's on the TVM team, by the way. But nobody really, well, there's somebody launched an attack, but nobody affecting the overall classification. Now, this is the composition of the breakaway. All the Italian flags there, except Klaus Møller of Denmark, breaking up the sequence. And this break knows that they're going to succeed today. It's a question of just planning which one of them is going to win.
Yeah, because everybody is trying to get off the front and win this stage as we head into the town now of Asiago.
Just a little split in the field here. The Kelme rider sitting at the back of the group. Möller is still here, the Danish rider. But there's a little bit of a scampering away from the front of the group here now. As they go, we've got Bettini, Scirea, Mario Scirea is here, the Seiko rider. There he is on the front, the big Seiko man. And Fontanelli is the little rider tucked in at the back. Remember, To the very stage a year ago, he was the winner, and he looks as though he's getting himself into a nice position. This is Paolo Bettini.
Bettini looks very nervous. He doesn't want the other group of the riders behind to come back up to them. About 800 metres to go, looking over his shoulder, and in fact, it's Bettini the first to move.
Well, he's gone very, very early. I think he's seen the left-hander in front, but he's eased right back again, and Fontanelli's come back into the lead now. Fontanelli can see the front of the race now, and he's going to give everything, but he's now... Bettini has got it first, gritting his teeth and going for it. Fontanelli has got Bettini's wheel, and it looks though the big Scirea isn't going to get in on the act here, but can Fontanelli get off the back wheel of Bettini? And I think he can. Stage 16, 2 years in a row. Fabio Fontanelli gets the stage at 25 miles an hour, the average speed today. Nothing to write home about. Flashing over the line there in fourth place is Mario Piccoli. So he keeps getting points in that competition. Fedegato fifth, Loda sixth, and Cassani seventh. None of the men that matter on the result poll because they're still coming in.
But a great move by Fontanelli, perfectly timed here. Bettini panicked a little bit, let it out, and Fontanelli was in an ideal position just to come off his shoulder and get himself the second win on stage 16 2 years in a row.
But in the end, of course, Alex Zülle coming in this back group will keep his pink jersey on the eve of the toughest stage, that's what they're saying, of this year's Giro d'Italia. Certainly a stage which crosses the highest mountains. So we come to the stage they've talked about long ago, even when the tour route was announced, 17th stage from Asiago to Selva di Valgardena. 200 plus kilometres. This is the overall situation as we go into the mountains today. Tonkoff looking for 202. Bettini is third. Pantani is down to fourth. Well, I say down to fourth, but he's been a challenger throughout this race. There's his team. And Paul, he knows today has to be his day.
A very difficult stage, and all the mountains really packed in the second half of the course. 100 kilometres from the finish is when all the big climbs start, and already riders out there trying to toughen it up. Riders who feel that they've got a chance of stealing an advantage over the big climbers. We're looking here at one of the riders on the new team. This is Buenahora riding for Vitalico Siguros from Spain, a man who's always ridden well here in the Tour of Italy and the Tour de France. A great climber, but certainly the hammer will come down behind, Phil, because we have got the Passo di Marmolada, the ride, the climb that many of these riders fear, and almost straight after that, the Passo di Sella, which this year is the Cima Coppi, the highest point of the Giro d'Italia, 2,200 metres, is down to a very select group of 30 riders, and Alex Zülle in the pink jersey there looking very comfortable at the front of the main group.
A lot of climbs today going over 2,200 metres, and so that's some in the region of 7,000 plus feet. And the riders know they have a real tough day, and decision time is here. Dmitry Konyshev in the centre of our picture, the rider who was the first Russian rider, well, the first Soviet Union rider to pull on the King of the Mountains leader's jersey in the Tour de France. Tonkoff decides to lift the pace a little bit. The first test, perhaps.
Tonkoff, very strong rider. He's definitely not a pure climber, but he climbs with power. Second in the overall standings, 2 minutes and 2 seconds behind Alex Zülle. And obviously the team to react is going to be Festina. They're not going to let Pavel Tonkoff ride away like that. But in that group, one man missing from the front of that group, in fact, Phil, was Marco Pantani, not riding up towards the front with the other big leaders.
Well, you know, he's going to have to go early if he does anything at all on this stage. He doesn't finish up a mountain, which is not really his favourite. It finishes almost downhill, in fact. And here's Pantani now, who climbed his way through with his usual rhythm. Fourth overall, 3 minutes 48. It's a big task to bridge 3:48 to a man like Alex Zülle, as he makes his way up now to the back wheel of Tonkoff, and right behind him there is Giuseppe Guerini, who finished third overall last year in the Giro.
Amazing the ease with which Marco Pantani rides up and down these groups in the mountains. 1 minute he's sitting right at the back, and when he feels there's a certain amount of danger, he just cruises up right round the outside and puts himself into an ideal position to keep an eye on what's going on. But it looks as if Alex Zülle is suffering a little bit because he's not quite on the wheel of the rider in front of him, but this is a chance to see the big power of Pavel Tonkoff.
Well, Zülle said last night he's not sure he will still lead the Tour by the end of tomorrow, and that's now today, as indeed Pantani has started that relentless rhythm again to see how many riders he can break.
Pantani loves climbing, and once he's got a chance of getting to the front of a small group like this, he just puts the pressure on it and accelerates to see who can follow the incredible changes of speed that he's got on these big mountain slopes, looking very concentrated at the moment. There's still a breakaway up the road of three riders, and one of those is Kamenzin, which is a very good tactical move, really, by the Mapei squad, because if Tonkov can get up to Kamenzin, then the Mapei squad is going to have the advantage of numbers. But look at this. You can't see the pink jersey of Alex Zullert following the pace.
Well, if you're not feeling good, there he is down there, Paul. And if you're not feeling good, today is not the day to wear the pink jersey. He knows that Pantani is moving clear with Tonkov, of course, and with Ghirini. Here they are, and Tonkov still making good pacemaking here, but this group is moving clear on the Marmolada. They're picking up the stragglers now of the early breakaways, and they're not going to stay with them at all. They're going to drop back.
Pantani looks across at the rider he's just passed there, looking over to see where Alex Zullert is, and Zullert is a long way down the road at the moment, suffering to get his condition, suffering to get into any kind of rhythm to control the pace that's being set currently by Marco Pantani. And Pantani, it always amazes me, Phil, to see him on the slopes of these climbs. It just looks so easy when he gets out of the saddle. Those legs of his just flow around, a very fluid motion.
Well, here comes little Kepi Gonzalez, who's a real great climber. And these are the last two survivors up front now, Paul, and looking here on the face of the Vitalico rider, he's not feeling too happy at all.
Two Colombians at the head of affairs now, Buenahora and Kepi Gonzalez. They know each other very well indeed, and certainly they will be getting information of what is happening behind. And the big reaction is coming from Marco Pantani, who needs, if he wants to climb further up the overall standings, to put a lot of time between himself and men like Tonkov and Alex Zullert. Now, in fact, Tonkov has been joined by Alex Zullert, so Zullert riding himself into some form of rhythm on this climb here, but in great difficulty trying to match any of the pace that has been set by Marco Pantani on the early slopes of this climb.
Well, it's a time for Pantani to get his own back on Zullert after that time trial when Zullert came flying by him at clearly almost a third quicker than he was going. Now we're on the mountain, and now Pantani can hurt Zullert here. But Zullert is a clever rider. He's not a man to panic. He's never one to say he can ride alongside Pantani. The thing is to find your own rhythm and climb this mountain at your speed. And with the strength and the talent of Zullert, he should be able to ride past the majority of the riders.
Well, the man doing the job at the moment is 141 Giuseppe Ghirini, who's still managing to stay in the slipstream of Marco Pantani. But I tell you one thing, the crowd certainly love this man. They're going crazy. They want Pantani to walk away with the Tour of Italy today. And he certainly is putting a lot of his adversaries into difficulties on the slopes of this climb, the Marmolada.
Well, you know, Ghirini had a great tour last year. He took over the job of team leader after Luc Leblanc slammed into that wall in the time trial and eventually retired from the race when he was right up there on a podium finish, and he came up to finish in third place and get a podium place. So he's a very good rider, Ghirini, and once you've proved that you can do it, then very often you come back and you repeat the feat. And right now, he knows if he controls Marco Pantani and goes with Marco Pantani, you can see the gaps that Pantani is opening, and then Ghirini can start dreaming of a high podium place again.
1 kilometer to go to the summit of the Col de Marmolada. That is Kepi Gonzalez still with a 1:45 advantage over the chasers, and not even a worry on the thought of Marco Pantani here. He's just trying to set the pace as much as he can to make sure that he can open up as much advantage on the guys behind him. He's not worried about Kepi Gonzalez. Gonzalez here thinking more about the possibility of getting over the top of this climb and keeping his advantage on the way towards the finish line. Well, that's a big surprise, because I thought Mario Cipollini was looking very comfortable over the last couple of days, but certainly he wasn't too happy when the rain and the cold weather came down on this year's Tour of Italy. As we come to the top of the climb, we get a chance now to see what sort of deficit Marco Pantani has over the leader, Kepi Gonzalez, and it's 1:19 over the summit of that climb, and there's still, Phil, an awful long way to go to the finish. It's around about 30 k's from the finish line.
Well, hats off to Alex Zullert, the way he's riding here at the moment, because he looks to me, Paul, as though he's actually finding his rhythm again, even though the gap is opening and that pink jersey could now be transferring across to Marco Pantani. But even if that is to be the case, with the time trial still to come, Zullert could take that jersey back for a fourth time.
What he has to do now is to make sure that he doesn't panic, to keep riding sensibly well within his limits, so on the flatter part of the course, he can actually recover and pull a bit of time back. But there is 3:08 behind the leader, so that puts him around about 2 minutes behind Marco Pantani.
Well, we'll see how the riders tackle that. The general opinion is the Marmalade is the tougher of the two climbs, but the other one is certainly higher. And we're forming at the front now, a group of five riders. Kamazin jumps on the back wheel there of Buenaher, it is the Colombian rider, and then Guerini and Pantani.
Well, that'll be somewhat of a shock for Kamazin, because he would have expected his own man Tonkov to be in that group. In fact, Tonkov was riding very well on the early slopes of this climb, and a lot further back down the main field is Alex Zuller, trying to make sure that he doesn't panic. He's got a very good group with him here now, so they'll all work together and try and limit their losses when they come to the bottom of the very next tough climb. Kepi Gonzalez had an advantage of over 3 minutes, but he hasn't got any advantage now, because the green jersey on the shoulders of the king of the mountains of this year's Giro d'Italia, Marco Pantani, has pulled him back into the fold.
And Pantani still must gain in excess of a minute and 20 seconds to get that pink jersey away from Alex Zuller. Zuller is riding a very clever race today. He's not trying to kill himself to hold Pantani. I think he accepts he can't do that, but he can limit his losses and maybe save the day. It's all down to Pantani and how much he can gain.
Pantani hasn't got any friends in this group here. Guerini sitting on his wheel. Two Colombians in there, Buenahora and Kepi Gonzalez. And of course, Oscar Kamen's in there, champion of Italy, of Switzerland. He's not going to give any help at all to the flying El Pirata.
Not when he's the teammate of Pavel Tonkov, who is still behind. I'll tell you what, Kamazin has been quite a revelation in the race here. Former winner of the Tour of Switzerland and also the national champion of his country. Now beginning to move smoothly into the big time of cycling. So I think he's a third year pro.
Well, there's a problem here with Marco Pantani. His chain's off. He looked as if he knew that was going to happen. He slowed down, moved to one side, and very quickly behind the team car, the team mechanic stopped, and he's up away. And I don't think very many people are going to ride away from Marco Pantani on this climb here as he picks his way up through straight past Buenahora.
Who looks as though he's hit the wall the way he was going there. He'd slowed right down, further down the slopes. We've got the pink jersey here, trying to just keep things as they are at the minute. Tonkov is with him.
Right on his shoulder in the yellow jersey there, the man who won a stage of the Alpe d'Huez as his first ever victory as a professional, Roberto Conti. But up the field, this is a great piece of racing by Marco Pantani. Kepi Gonzalez tried to take advantage of that little mechanical incident, as did Guerini, who was just a little bit around the corner in front of Marco Pantani, but no panic for the Italian.
Talking of Conti there, Paul, you said his first ever victory. I think it's still the only victory he's ever had. Not a bad one to put on your list, though, is it? Tonkov.
If you're going to win one race in your career, it might as well be the Alpe d'Huez, and certainly Roberto Conti will think about that victory for many years to come. But now he's a great teammate to have for Marco Pantani, because he's the kind of rider who is solid whenever it comes to these big three-week races. And Pantani pulling himself very easily back to the front of this race and catching up with Guerini.
So the head of the race, as they continue to climb through this beautiful valley here in the South Tyrolean mountains. Now we cross the road here and move on to the continuation of this climb, where it gets a little bit steeper, and 20 kilometers to go to the line. Still a long way, past a long chance for Pantani to build on his lead. Remember, once we see that lead climb up over 3 minutes 48 seconds over Zuller, then Pantani will literally be in the pink. Well, Pantani getting a little bit of help now from Guerini, because Guerini, I think, will begin to believe in himself here to survive with Marco Pantani over these two steep climbs. Tonkov is not dropping any further back, Paul, and is looking quite good as well.
1 minute, 53 seconds. He started the day 2 minutes and 2 seconds behind Zuller, but in fact, he was only 1 minute and 48 seconds ahead of Marco Pantani. So I would think Marco Pantani now is almost leader on the road, but you cannot discount Pavel Tonkov. He's still got an awful long way to go to the finish. And from the top of the final climb, you'd go downhill very quickly, 15 kilometers the descent off this mountain to the finish line.
Guerini should pick up the advantage then if he hangs on to Pantani all the way over the ripples. And that will certainly lift him back up into the overall leaders as well. And he'd be pretty happy with that.
He certainly will. And once again, as they go over the summit, he's waving the flag for Polti, because last year he finished in this race in third in the overall standings after taking over the leadership from Luc Leblanc. And he's proved to be a very solid rider indeed. And Pavel Tonkov now approaching the summit of the climb. We'll get a chance to see just what sort of damage has been done by Marco Pantani.
Well, Tonkov over the years has been a man of the Giro. He knows what it's like to wear the Maglie Rosa. He knows what it's like, in fact, to win the event. And so he's not going to give up easy. Just 1 kilometre to go of what the riders claim is the toughest stage of this year's race. There will be a change in leadership. It's only a question of will it go from Zulla to Tonkoff or from Zulla to Pantani.
And Zulla looking very difficult there. Guarini's taking the advantage here over Pantani, who's trying to get onto his back wheel.
So, Guarini gets the result, and that's a great result. Pantani content with second. The clock starts now, and we wait to see whether the jersey goes to Pantani or Tonkoff. But I think that Guarini will be a top four contender after that ride today. And this is the rest of the race coming in. Kepi Gonzalez, one by one, they're just going to drift in. 2:02 to Tonkoff, so he will not get the pink jersey. It will go to Pantani, providing that Zulla has not made some form of miraculous descent and has pinched back a little bit of time. There's Kamazin at 2:16 down. He'll get the fifth place finish, by the way. And thankfully, we haven't had to go quite that high in the race today, which is probably as well for everybody, except Pantani. Here comes Zulla now. The clock says it all. He's out of the pink jersey. He's lost it again. He lost it to Gonchar, and then he lost it to Laurent Roux, and now he's going to lose it to Marco Pantani. The time gaps are big, but not too big with the time trial still to come. 4:36 the gap. And on the stage now, what a comeback after those horrible years of his major injury when he was thought he would never walk again, never mind ride a bike. Marco Pantani now leads the Giro d'Italia. A magnificent performance by Il Pirato. He's won a stage in the race. He finished second today. He probably let Guarini get that one. He was happy enough to live in the hope that he would pull on at the Maglia Rosa. Fantastic.
For the first time in his career, he puts the Maglia Rosa onto his shoulders, and he certainly is going to appreciate that, because there are still some very more difficult stages to come, and he doesn't have a major advantage over Pavel Tonkoff. You can see, Phil, only 30 seconds and 31 seconds to Guarini, who really made the operation of the day, and Alex Zulla dropping down into fourth place, 1 minute and 1 second behind, still not too far back.
And the arrival of Oscar Kamazin now, he's up into fifth place. So this tour is not finished yet. There's still a lot to come.